We are here this evening to honour a truly remarkable singer, a voice, who's made an outstanding contribution to the field of jazz music. Now, his expressive and lyrical vocal has brought the jazz genre to the mainstream consciousness. He has had a meteoric rise to celebrity. It is a testament to his broad popular appeal, which he's enjoying all around the world. I have seen his tour schedule everywhere, all the corners. To put it simply, he has put jazz back on the map, but he's done it Porter style. Now he's currently on tour promoting his fifth album, Nat King Cole and Me. He's going to perform a few songs from that classic repertoire today. We're very, very lucky. But first, I have a few questions to put to the man. So please, will you help me to welcome the amazing Gregory Porter. It's wonderful to have you here. How are you finding it here in England?
Amazing. I'm always enjoying myself when I'm here, yeah.
Good. I always have to ask, British people, we always ask this, how are you enjoying the cold?
It's all right.
That's exactly. Okay, so I have a couple of questions. Thank you, first of all, for being here. We are honoured to be honouring you today. You have this amazing new album, Nat King Cole and Me.
Yeah.
Why do a tribute album to Nat King Cole?
This really is a tribute album in the truest sense. I came to Nat's music when I was about 6 years old in the absence of my father, and I heard this amazing, rich voice coming out of the speakers, saying these words, these positive words, pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and start all over again, smile. You know, the greatest thing you'll ever learn is just to love and be loved in return. Those were serious words of, in a way, fatherly advice. I wasn't having it from my own father. So, in a way, Nat filled a void. And so, he's been with me for a long time. And the music has been with me for a long time. And I had the opportunity and a great orchestra here in London. So, yeah, it was a dream come true, really.
Amazing. And did you feel any pressure then singing those words yourself? Do you feel that you're handing it down to the next generation?
I am. I feel like I'm handing it to my son in a way. Some of those words, some of those songs have influenced me. If you like, you know, there will be no lovers dying here. If you like that, then maybe the initial inspiration for that is, you know, the greatest thing you'll ever, maybe the inspiration for that is Nature Boy. If you like, you know, Don't Lose Your Steam, sitting on the top of the roof, the bridge is all mine. If you like that, then the inspiration for that is probably pick yourself up, dust yourself off. You understand what I'm saying?
It is fascinating. So, yeah. Amazing. Now, we are going to hear you sing, but having witnessed you before, your voice comes across so powerful and so effortless. Mm. You may not agree doing the actual thing, but where has that voice come from?
I'm synthesizing in a way my culture, my mother. Sometimes I close my eyes and I can feel my mother, you know, on my shoulder in a way. And I say it all the time, and I'm gonna keep saying it until the end of my career. I feel my grandmother, my grandma, just all my people are in the music, and that's real. I mean, growing up in church, sitting in the front row, I mean, that's there. You know, my brothers watching Soul Train, my brother's music, listening, you know, to the OJs, all of that music. I'm trying to put it into my musical expression.
Now, people say that you have rise to this meteoric fame and celebrity, and I know underground you would have been working years and years before all of that. Being able to go around the world, see different cultures, amazing people, what drives you and what keeps you grounded?
I think the fact that I've been able to go to so many places around the world and eliminate those things that separate us, You know, when I go to, we went to South Africa for the first time, and there was 10,000 South Africans singing my lyrics back to me, better than I could sing them. You know how South Africans do, you know, it's a sound, you know? And, you know, going to Brazil and Germany and so, you know, the idea that these inspirations come in a little quiet place, and then you take it out and you get to share it with the rest of the world, that's extraordinary. That's extraordinary. I get to say something about my mother to people all over the world, you know? You know, my brothers, they know some of the inspirations of some of the songs, and it'll be just some family moment that happened. But I get to share it with people all over the world, so it's just a beautiful thing.
It's a lucky thing to do.
Yeah.
Amazing. Now, we are also joined by a fantastic pianist here. Can you tell me who we joined
That's
by?
Chip Crawford. We met maybe 10, 11 years ago now at a little club in Harlem called Satan's Pub. And we've been playing together ever since. And he's my musical right hand. And we've done everything together. And, you know, we're going to keep riding until the wheels fall off. You know?
Here. And what will you be singing for us?
I'm going to do a couple of songs from the Nat King Cole and Me project, Mona Lisa, and a song that I wrote, when I sat down to write the song, I was like, if I were going to write a song for Nat King Cole, what would it be? And so, When Love Was King.
Amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Gregory Porter.
When love was king, he showed respect for every man, regardless of his skin and clan.
It is truly a proud moment to be here tonight and to be able to honour our 2017 outstanding contribution to music to Gregory Porter.
All right. Wow. 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 How beautiful.
He lifted up. He lifted up the people that were on the underneath.
This really is an honor. The acceptance that I've had from the UK audience has been really extraordinary and really something. And so thank you so much. And also just the meaning of this award. I feel like I'm standing on the shoulders of some people who've gone through some things. And that's what comes out when I sing the lyric, he lifted up the underneath and all of his wealth he did bequeath. I'm talking about the people that have been on the underneath before. There's an energy and a fuel that drives my music. And you know where it comes from. God bless you. Thank you so much.